as a home brewer, I don't have a production schedule. I am very much more relaxed about letting the yeast do its job. I could leave a fermenter with beer in it for 2, 3, possibly 4 weeks. If I am not able to take it to the next step, the process allows me a lot more relaxation. It's not a job. I'm not producing it for anybody but myself. So I let things take a little bit more natural course. I will either bottle or keg my beers. And I typically will re-ferment in that bottle or keg to get my carbonation. And then that process is another couple weeks of natural fermenting at room temperature. Whatever sugar I add to the keg or bottle is converted by the yeast that's still suspended in there. You know, the beer is a living thing. As much as you try to filter it out, there'll still be some residual yeast there. And if yeast is there, it'll want to live and convert sugars into alcohol and carbon dioxide. So, all right, the different strains of yeast available to homebrewers are as wide as commercially produced. They're numbered as well. You know, there are a lot of commercial yeast factories that produce English-style yeasts, American-style yeast, Belgian-style yeast, German-style yeasts. They all have different flavor profiles associated with them and different temperatures that they will ferment more efficiently. Ale yeasts are a warmer fermenting yeast, very conducive to a home brewer's household. You don't need any extra refrigeration. There is a consistent flavor profile provided with those different kinds of yeasts. You'll get more floral and nutty and fruity esters from other types of yeast, like Belgian yeasts. Different fusel alcohols, phenol alcohols, a lot of the different yeasts provide a different flavor profile. And whatever you're looking for in your beer, you can match that flavor profile with a particular kind of yeast that you'd like. The flavor is affected by the yeast after prolonged exposures and various characteristics. If you leave your yeast in your beer for an extended period of time without any refrigeration, you expose yourself to a possibility of that yeast actually decomposing in your beer. That decomposition will have different effects. Some effects you might like, some effects you might not like. Typically, you can do what's called a secondary fermentation, where after the first week of fermentation in whatever you're fermenting in, you can pull off the yeast or a large amount of the yeast, and then the effects of that decomposition, if you were to leave that over an extended period of time, would decrease significantly. Also, a cold conditioning also reduces the breakdown of those yeasts as well. So if you want to secondary your beer in a refrigerated environment, you would reduce the amount of decomposition of those yeasts in your beer.